Visalia Chaudhary. I'm aged 81 years. I have taken to this drawing and painting right from my childhood. I was very fond of nature and especially flowers because my father was a very fond of gardening, and we always had a small garden with lawn and all. And I admired those flowers, especially their shading, their color, their fragrance. So I used to sit and study in my garden. Most of the time I used to be in my garden. From that time only, I started drawing flowers and coloring them. And still, I find that is the most interesting thing for me. Otherwise, I had, after marriage and having three daughters, I had almost given up my art. But these two daughters, Nilanjana and Niharika, made me start drawing again for the last, I think, 5 years or so. Then they gave me colors and pencil and brush and everything and asked me to start drawing again. Then I am reminded of my young days when I learnt art from a very, very talented teacher from Shantiniketan. Her name was Mrs. Prabha Pamar. She told me, at that time my husband was posted in Lucknow, and somehow I met her again in Lucknow. I studied at Meerut in RG College, and after getting married, my husband was in irrigation department, so we were getting transferred from one place to another. But then finally when we came to Lucknow, then Mrs. Pamar asked me, "Ki, how about your art? What are you doing?" I said, "Oh, I have forgotten about it. I have stopped doing it." "Tell me why so?" "You join my college." At that time, she was the head of the Department of Home Arts and Craft of Lucknow Arts College. Then I said, "It will be very difficult for me. I have three daughters." Then my husband also told me, "Ki, no, you go ahead and join the college." Then I joined in 70s. I joined this diploma course in art and craft where I learned batik, clay modeling, and nature study, block printing, and so many other arts. Since then, I was become a teacher, art teacher. Earlier, I was teaching political science. Then after doing this course of 3 years art, I became an art teacher. After becoming that, when we came to Bombay in 93, then again my daughters told me to start drawing. Since then, I have been drawing. So what I want to say, that I have used almost right from batik color to oil to pastel to charcoal and acrylic colors. But what I like most is watercolor. Nothing like watercolors. If you want to give the natural look to any object, any article, any flower, plant, landscape, then nothing like watercolors. I didn't have very good set of watercolors with me. Then my grandson, who was doing his PhD in Germany, told me, "Nani, I will get you colors." He bought me a big box of Winsor & Newton tube colors. They were really good, and the brushes. In our times, we used to get sable hair brushes, but now we don't get those. Still, these brushes are good. So I started doing these flowers. You see the flowers at the background. I can show you the ones on the left is Gulmohar, which is a very popular flower in India. And it is done with watercolor, and I'll show you how to sketch it and how to use the watercolors. Unfortunately, I don't have watercolors with me, but still, I'll tell you how to use. And the other one is Kachnar. I don't know the English name of this, but it is Kachnar. It has got beautiful buds. In UP, we eat these buds. So this is quite rare in Maharashtra, but still we get to see these normal natural plants. So now I'll start explaining to you from how to do the sketching of these flowers. The sketching is very important. You have to do sketching with very light hand. For watercolor painting, minimum sketching is required. You use pencil with very soft pencil with very light hand, the way I'm using it. Now you can focus on it. Just a symbol, because the watercolors are very transparent. They catch it in no time, what you have drawn. So there should not be any pencil marks left on the paper. You should draw with this kind of light hand, hardly showing anything. Rest you have to do with your brush only. So this is how one draws with pencil and minimum use of eraser, because the eraser will make the paper rough and the watercolor won't do. So you use minimum, you take out very little color from your tube and then water, mix it with water and just do the shading with other brush. I don't have colors with me because at this lockdown time I am staying with my daughter. Here I don't have my colors or anything, otherwise I would have shown you how to color it. Anyways, that we can tell sometimes later. Then do it with that. And other thing you can do with watercolor is doing single stroke. Single stroke means you use one flat brush and just on one side of the brush you take one color. On the other side you can take the other color, just showing the mixing of two with your hand only. It brings out beautiful results. So this is about watercolor painting, and I know nowadays mostly people are preferring acrylic colors. So now I have in my Alpana drawing, I learned from my Shantiniketan teacher again. Alpana itself is a beautiful art that everybody knows how to do. In all the states, it is used for all the festive occasions, right from birth to death. So every Alpana has different kind of motifs, different kind of material used. Here we call it Rangoli. We do it with these dry colors, but in Uttar Pradesh, we do it with rice, grounded rice mixed with water and with cotton. We do it with the finger and cotton on the floor only. Like that, in Shantiniketan also, they do it with flowers, with colors, with rice powder and everything. And this, I have one painting you might have seen of white elephant. It is Iravat, Indra's elephant, where I have used. That is Shantiniketan style of Alpana. And after doing this Alpana, I learnt clay modeling and batik also. Here I have done one in charcoal pens. Charcoal I had never used earlier. My granddaughter told me how to use charcoal and how to use the shading and all with charcoal, which I made this Kaushalyaji taking out milk from the cow. You must have seen the painting over there. This, and then Bharti Miss, my daughter's teacher, also told me how to use charcoal. That is also a good medium. And acrylic I use for my folk art. Folk art I learned from my grandmother. Olden days we used to have these kind of motifs mostly for all the major festivals like Holi, Diwali, Karwa Chauth, and each painting, I'll show you one painting of Deepavali, which is with me now. This is a folk art Deepavali. This folk art shows one story how we started worshipping Diwali, Deepavali. They say ki there were five ladies who have their husbands, one husband is shown over here, they were very fond of drinking. Then they got very fed up, they became very poor, they spent all the money in drinking. Then they worshipped Lakshmi, Ganesh and the nature. You see, the nature is shown by showing Suraj, Chandrama and this is Ganga, Jamuna and plants, Tulsi. They started praying. Then next Diwali, by next Diwali, their husbands gave up drinking and there was prosperity in their house and lights and everything. So they started doing puja of Diwali. This, the five heads are of Diwali. They are depicting Diwali, five heads, her hands, hand feet, everything is shown over here. So these kind of stories were there for this folk art. So this is done in acrylic because it is very attractive. And we paste these things on the wall. But earlier we were doing the drawing on the wall itself by doing it with cow dung, making it very smooth with cow dung, and when it dried, then using green leaves to make the color look khaki. So those green leaves, when they were done on the cow dung, they used to give a beautiful color. On that, we were supposed to draw, my grandmother made us draw with broom sticks and rice powder. It used to look quite attractive. She was very talented. She taught us so many things about our religious drawings. So since then, we have been doing these kind of drawings. Now, I want all the old ladies as well as gents to come out with their talent. I know everyone has something, some talent. May it be music, performing art, crochet, knitting or stitching, anything, whatever art you have in your hand, whatever you feel like doing, you must do it. Age is no bar. I also thought, yeah, I'm old, I won't be able to do it now. But when I start drawing, my hand does not shake. I'm so much involved, I forget about eating food or having water or something that I'm feeling very hungry or I'm feeling very hot. Nothing matters. You go ahead with your passion and start working, especially at this time of lockdown when there is plenty of time at our hands. We hardly go out, we cannot go out. So create something, the creativity, the art. Art is known as Swanta Sukhai. We all know ki art kis liye karte hai? For our own good and our own happiness. So creativity gives you happiness, so go ahead and create. Don't mind if it is good or bad. Ultimately it will become good and people will admire it. You have done it. It is done with your hands. I do block printing and fabric painting also because these are the things of utility everybody is using in the house, and have participated in so many exhibitions where all the stuff is sold. People like having handmade things. So go ahead and start it. So thank you for listening and giving me time. Bye-bye. Namaste.